تبسم 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 تبسم
تبسم تبسم وخل الهموم وخل الغموم وخل الضجاع ولا تبتئس من صروف الزمان.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Respected viewers, welcome once again to our synopsis of ayats recited at the time of Taraweeh. Today we are doing the 20th juz. And the 20th juz coincides with the end of Surah An-Naml. And it starts off in such a unique way, speaking about the greatness of Almighty Allah, and makes human being ponder about the greatness of Almighty Allah. And Al-Talaf, for example, says in the first verse, أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Who created the heavens and earth? وَأَنزَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً Who send down rain from the heavens. فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ حَدَائِكْ Because of that rain, you found vegetation that has grown. ذَاتَ بَحْجَةٍ Which is so glamorous, so beautiful. مَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَن تُنْبِتُوا شَجَرَهَا You don't have the capacity to bring forth that vegetation. أَإِلَهٌ مَّعَ اللَّهِ Is it anyone else besides Allah? بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ يَعْدِلُونَ But oh human being, you associate partners to Almighty Allah. You make someone equal to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next five verses goes on to make mention with regard to certain similar type of phenomena. Look at this. أَمَّ يُجِيبُ الْمُطَّرَّ إِذَا دَعَى Who is the one who responds to the call of those people who are in difficulty? وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ And removes the difficulty from people. وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ Who has made you Allah's representative on this earth. أَيْلَاهُمْ مَا اللَّهِ Is it anyone else besides Allah? But yet you don't, Kalilam, very few people reflect upon this aspect. أَمَّا يَهْدِيكُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ Who is the one who, أَمَّا يَهْدِيكُمْ Who guides you فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ In the darkness of the horizon and in the earth and in the ocean. And we find this, you know, you're sometimes traveling in the night on an aeroplane and you feel, how is this aeroplane being directed in a particular direction? Allah says, I am the one who is guiding the plane in a particular direction. وَمَنْ يُرْسِلُ الرِّيَاحَ بُشْرًا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَحْمَتِي Who brings winds that gives tidings of glad, of good rains to follow? أَمَّا يَبْدَعُ الْخَلْقِ Who is the one who initiated creation? ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ And once again will resurrect people on the day of Qiyamah. وَمَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ Who is the one who grants you sustenance in the heavens and earth? أَيْلَاهُمَّ اللَّهِ Is it anyone else besides Allah? In this beautiful way, this juz starts off by reminding us about the greatness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for us to reflect upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's imprint upon each and every aspect with the intention for us to turn towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the fourth ruku of the juz, Allah ta'ala starts a surah known as Suratul Qasas. Qasas mean incidents. So Allah has made mention of various incidents. One of the incidents Allah has made mention is the incident of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the beginning of his creation. Allah ta'ala says after he was born, it was a time of great difficulty upon the Bani Israel. Fir'aun was slaughtering and killing the male children of Bani Israel. So when the mother of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam gave birth to him, she was very worried. So Allah ta'ala says, we inspired into our heart, an ardi'i, don't worry, we will protect him. And you continue breastfeeding him. But a mother is a mother. فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ And Allah Ta'ala inspired and said, if for any reason you are not satisfied with that, فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ Put him into a small, basket, فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمِ Leave him, وَلَا تَخَافِ وَلَا تَحْزَنِي Do not be afraid, do not be sad, إِنَّا رَادُّهُ إِلَيْكِ We will return him back to you and we will make him amongst the great prophets. So Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala inspired that to the mother of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. She did that. That went and it went through the River Nile. Eventually it came into the court of Fir'aun, where Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun, was there. And Allah Ta'ala says, وَقَالَتِ امْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكْ لَا تَقْتُلُوا When she saw this beautiful child, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was a Nabi of Allah, most handsome, full of nur, even when he was young. And she said, لَا تَقْتُلُوا Don't kill him. أَسَعِي يَنْفَعَنَا Asiya did not have any children with Fir'aun. She said, perhaps he would be of benefit to us. أو نتخذه ولدا. Or we will adopt him and make him our son. وهم لا يشعرون. But she did not know the reality. She felt that he would be of benefit to her in this material world. Allah planned otherwise. ومكروا ومكر الله. Allah, we planned. Allah plans, and Allah is the best of planners, because Allah Ta'ala made Musa alayhi salatu wasalam a means of a hidayat, because she brought Iman upon Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam later on in her life. Then as the incident continues, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when Fir'aun tried to get different people to breastfeed Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, no one was. Hazrat Musa alayhi salam did not take anyone's breast. So the sister of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, sent by the mother of Hazrat Musa, went past and said, I know of a woman who is very compassionate, who is very kind towards this child, who will breastfeed the child, and the child will not refuse the milk of this mother or this woman. And Allah Ta'ala says, فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ. Then Fir'aun brought her back to the mother of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, who breastfeeded her, and the expenses was borne by Fir'aun and Hazrat Asiya. So Allah Ta'ala says, فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ. We brought her back to the home of her mother, كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَعْزَن, so that her eyes could be comforted, and for her to realize that Allah made a promise, and Allah Ta'ala does not go against his promise. The incident goes on. Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam becomes a teenager. He becomes young in the palace of Fir'aun. And one day, Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the incident is a long one, just very briefly to go into it. Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam sees two people fighting. One is a Qibti, one is an Egyptian, one is a Bani Israel. Because the Bani Israel calls out to Musa, oh Musa, this person is oppressing me. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam comes to his assistance. And then in coming to his assistance and protecting this person from the Egyptian dies. And then the next day, Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam goes and sees the same person of Bani Israel fighting with someone else. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said, it looks like you are the troublemaker. And he said, and he slipped out from his tongue and he said, Ya Musa, aturidu an taqtulani kama qatalta nafsan bil ams. Are you going to kill me the way you killed that Egyptian person yesterday? But that at that time, no one knew who killed that Egyptian. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, it came to be known that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was responsible, although it was not done deliberately. And then Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, one of the people who was in the court of Fir'aun, came to tell Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Ya Musa, innal mal'a ya'tamirunaka bika liyaqtuluk. The people want to kill you, therefore you leave the city. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam leaves the city. He comes to a place called Madian. And Allah Ta'ala makes mention with regard to it. وَوَجَدَ مِن دُونِهِمُ مُرْعَتَيْنِ تَذُودَانِ قَالَ مَا خَدْبُكُمَا. He comes to Madian. He finds the people around a water hole. He finds two women upon whom there are signs of dignity and modesty. And he finds them that they are away from the crowd. And he asks them, why are you away from the crowd? And they said, we do not want to go and take water while other people are taking. At the opportune time, with modesty, we would be able to go and take and draw the water. And our father, being the male, he is sickly and he is ill. Therefore, he cannot do this task. So Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, فَسَقَى لَهُمَا. Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam helps them. And when he helps them, they go back and report back to their father. In the meanwhile, Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam is completely alone. And not only alone, he does not have anyone to look after him. He does not have any finance. He does not have anyone with regard to necessities of life. And he made this beautiful dua, رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Oh Allah, I'm in poverty of any good that you can send upon me. The two girls go and report back to their father. And they said that this person is someone who helped us. They came earlier than usual. So the Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam, who was their father, said, go and fetch him, that we can thank him for what he had done. So they bring Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to Hazrat Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam. One of the daughters of Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam said, Ya Abati Istajir. Oh, our father, employ him. He will work for us. And we employ him because you are old. We are women folk. Inna khayra man ista'jarta al-qawiyul amin. Two criteria for people whom you must employ, we learned from this incident. The best of people to employ are those people who are trustworthy and they know their task. Mi khayra man ista'jarta al-qawiyul amin. They have the strength. Our ulama have made mention strength would mean either physical strength or the strength and the capacity to do what they have been entrusted with. And he's also trustworthy. And on that particular basis, Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam employs him. And then Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam gets him married to one of his daughters. So this incident is also made mention of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted refuge to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in a foreign land when he left Egypt for the reason that I have outlined. And then he came back to Egypt with Nabuwat and prophethood. And he came back to Fir'aun to invite him towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala later on in life. In the 56th verse of the surah, Allah Ta'ala speaks about a very important principle. إِنَّكَ لَا تَحْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْ. Allah Ta'ala tells our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you cannot give hidayah to whom you love. In Sahih Muslim, there is a riwayat and narration that this ayat was revealed after Abu Talib did not die upon iman. This caused great sadness to our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Abu Talib helped Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam physically and in many ways, but he did not die upon iman. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was distressed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayat, إِنَّكَ لَا تَحْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You cannot give hidayah to whom you love. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah will grant hidayah to whomsoever He wills. Listeners and viewers, it is so important that we always seek hidayah from Almighty Allah. We do not know whether we will die upon hidayah to iman. Therefore, we need to make this dua with great passion. For hidayah is only in the hands of Allah. When Allah Ta'ala wants to give hidayah, He can even give hidayah to the son of Abu Jahl, one of the greatest disbelievers in the entire history of humanity. When Allah Ta'ala doesn't want to give hidayah, then we find that even the uncle of our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the son of Nuh alayhi salatu wa sallam, the wife of Hazrat Lut alayhi salatu wa sallam, the son of Nuh alayhi salatu wa sallam, they are without iman and without hidayah. May Allah Ta'ala always guide us and provide us His hidayah till the last moments of our life. Allah Ta'ala in verse 71 speaks about a phenomena where He reminds us about His greatness for us to reflect and come closer towards Almighty Allah. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ. Say and look at this. If Allah Ta'ala were to extend the night till the day of Qiyamah, and there is no daylight, there is no rising of the sun, who is there besides Allah who will bring the sun to rise and give you light that you require to be refreshed and to be able to complete your task? قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Look at this phenomena. If Allah Ta'ala were to extend the day till the day of Qiyamah, and Allah does not envelop the day with darkness and night, مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَعْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ. Who will bring the darkness of the night? Who will bring the covering of the night? تَسْكُرُونَ فِي, that you may gain rest in the night. وَمِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ, it is among the signs of Allah. جَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لِتَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَلِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Allah Ta'ala grants you the night to gain rest. And Allah Ta'ala grants you the day to be able to gain your sustenance. Only Allah Ta'ala's rahmat that Allah Ta'ala grants us. Towards the second last ruku of the surah, Allah Ta'ala speaks about Qarun. إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى. Qarun was from the tribe and the family of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, but he was rebellious. وَأَتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ. Allah Ta'ala granted him that amount of wealth. And without exaggeration, we can say he had more wealth than anyone else that in today's time possesses that type of wealth. No one could have that type of wealth that he has. Allah Ta'ala gives an example of his wealth. وَأَتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِهَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ وَلِلْقُوَّةِ. Never mind his wealth. It needed a strong contingent of strong people to be able to carry the keys of his wealth. Now, can you imagine his wealth when he needed a whole group of people to carry the keys of his wealth? But instead of realizing that that wealth came from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, instead of turning towards Almighty Allah who had favored him with that wealth, Qarun became rebellious. And because of his rebelliousness and the dua of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Qarun, together with his wealth, was swallowed up by the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْعَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِيَةِ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. He was swallowed up by the earth and no one could come to his assistance. Therefore, even if you have wealth, realize that wealth didn't come because of your acumen. Didn't come because of you. It was given to you by Allah. Turn towards Almighty Allah. Don't make that wealth make you proud and arrogant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us about that lesson through the means of the incident of Qarun, which is made mention in Surah Al-Qasas. Towards the end of the juz, right towards the end, the last quarter, we start a surah known as Surah Al-Ankabut. Ankabut means spider. Now in the first ruku of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about kindness towards our parents. But of course there is a rider. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا. Allah Ta'ala commands and emphasizes upon human being that human being must be kind towards their parents. Now we know that kindness to parents has been greatly emphasized. In our earlier programs we made mention how Allah Ta'ala spoke about how we should be kind towards our parents, especially when they are in old age. what type of dua that we must make to them. But bear one principle in mind. There is only one being whose obedience is at all times without any restriction. And that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's obedience. Therefore Allah ta'ala says, وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ لِتُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِي عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا. If your parents force you to associate partners to Almighty Allah, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, then do not follow them. لَا تَعَتَ الْمَخْلُوقِ فِي مَعْصِيَةِ الْخَالِقِ. There is no obeying the creation if it means disobeying Allah. Allah's obedience is supreme. And everyone else's obedience, sometimes you have to obey your parents because Allah has told us. But that particular obedience comes with a rider, comes with a condition that they must not tell you to do something that is against the commands of Almighty Allah. If they tell you to do something, or anyone else for that matter, tells you to do something against the commands of Almighty Allah, they are no more worthy of obedience. But even then, when you do speak to them, still be respectful to them, even if they have told you something that is not right and they are no more worthy of your obedience. Then too, you must be respectful. In the last page of the Juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the surah upon which it is entitled to. The surah is known as the surah of the spider. Ankabut means spider. And Allah says, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَوْلِيَاءَكَ مَثَلِ الْأَنْكَبُوتِ اتَّخَذَتْ بَيْتَ وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتُ الْأَنْكَبُوتِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. That the example of whomsoever you seek as a protector besides Allah, the example of anyone whom you seek as a protector besides Allah, that example is like the example of the web of the spider. اتَّخَذَتْ بَيْتَ. The spider also spins a web. وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ. The most weakest of all homes is the spider web. We know even a small child can take it and in one blow can bring down the web of the spider. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the example of anyone seeking assistance besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like clutching at the web of a spider. In another place of the Holy Quran, Allah ta'ala speaks about the weakness of creation compared to the greatness of Almighty Allah. In fact, towards the end of this supara, we just read, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَعْبُرُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ لَكُمْ رِزْكًا. Whomsoever you worship besides Allah, they do not have control over risk. فَابْتَغُوا إِنَّ اللَّهِ رِزْك. Seek risk from Almighty Allah. Another place in the Holy Quran, whomsoever you worship, whomsoever you seek assistance from besides Allah, لَن يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا. They can't even create a fly. وَإِيَسْلُبْهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُهُ مِنْ. And if the fly takes something away from them, they can't retrieve it from the fly. Why do you seek assistance from things that are so weak? And Allah Ta'ala in this ayat, and that is why the surah is entitled and known as Surah Ankabut, the surah of the spider, Allah Ta'ala says, seeking assistance and taking protection from anyone else besides Allah is like taking protection from a spider web and leaving the greatness of Almighty Allah, leaving what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can grant us. Allah Ta'ala says, ni'ma al-mawla wa ni'ma al-nasir. He is the best of helpers. He is the best of patrons, the best of protectors. Therefore, this surah, known as Ankabut, the surah of the spiders, gives us a great reminder. If you need anything, turn towards Almighty Allah. Whomsoever you seek assistance of besides Allah, it is like clutching at the web of the spider. And we all know, وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتَ الْأَنْكَبُوتِ. The weakest of all homes is the web of the spider. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us always turn towards Him in all our situations, in ease and adversity, and ever we are in difficulty, let us call towards Almighty Allah. He is the best of protectors. He is the best that can grant us. For in that, we have then put our trust upon the most powerful. The way Allah ta'ala says in Surah Talaq, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. And he who relies upon Almighty Allah, Allah becomes sufficient for him. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. لنحس في أعماقنا الإيمان.